We're in a very exciting era of medical science right now. I like to think of it as peeling an onion. Through the years, and particularly in the past 50 to 100 years, we've seen that onion peel back.
Really, there's been an explosion of understanding.
Cancers that were once thought to be untreatable are sometimes, in fact, now cured.
Invasive cervical cancer is almost a thing of the past. We've made tremendous strides against breast cancer. Still much work to be done.
At this moment in history, we are in a constant state of searching.
There's something going on groundbreaking right now.
It's providing us with an incredible opportunity to understand cancer in a way we never did.
We are on the verge to really unravel the genetic makeup of cancer.
The future of cancer care at USC and at Norris is truly bright.
We all share the same vision. We are committed to make cancer a disease of the past.
It's a vision that, I have to tell you, while it's a very lofty vision, it's really why we're all in healthcare and why we're here at USC.
This battle is not over, but we are winning. And I dream big. I dream of the day when this will be a disease of the past.
When cancer therapies were first developed, they really were developed as a one-size-fits-all approach. As it turns out, we now know cancer is a disease of DNA.
We peel the layer back where we can actually dissect out the very genes, the very control mechanisms that make a cancer cell act the way it does.
A lot of the work is on sort of the new science of genomics and epigenetics.
There may be genes which become turned off, which should be turned on. It's rather like having a door that's locked. Take a key and you unlock the door and you turn the gene back on again.
What we're trying to do is to achieve much more informed precision cancer care.
How can we use smart medications, smart therapies that target the bad cell and leave the good cells unscathed?
What we are talking about going forward is targeted, image-guided surgery.
We can draw some blood from you and then we sequence your DNA. We can then tailor the therapy.
We look at your genome and learn something about your environment.
It's a revolution in medical science with all the new technology we have.
We discover. We're pushing the envelope.
Norris has always tried to make sure that we remember our mission to make cancer a disease of the past by constantly moving the goalposts.
To effectively carry out the best research, you need team science.
You really need a fusion of chemistry, of biology, of medicine. USC has provided a very stable ground for us to do that.
This is where you see the cutting-edge research that takes place with a world-class patient care.
We are actually in a hospital where we have patient care and research and education all in the same place.
Being in the same place where the patients are, where the pathologists are, where the surgeons are, where the medical oncologists are, where the basic researchers are, that is what makes the Norris special.
We're working on projects that are just one or two steps away from being on the bedside.
I meet with basic scientists every week. They see something in the lab, I test it in the clinic, I see something in the clinic, and we go back.
My relationship with Dr. Lenz and Norris is one that kind of allows me to participate, if you will, in my own care.
Look, you may not be dealing with cancer now, but if you have to, you want this center to be there for you.
We're very proud of our contributions over the past 40 years, but when I look to the next 40 years, I know that we're going to have an even greater impact.
My dream for the future is that one of those scientists working in a laboratory is someday going to find the switch that turns off this damn disease.
We all should be soldiers in this effort. Look, I can't have this disease around when my daughter is my age. It's kind of that simple.
Private philanthropy provides us with vital resources. It helps ensure that advances in medicine will continue in the future.
This is our opportunity.
Now is the time.
You're really standing on the precipice of science.
We are equipped for the next generation, for the next millennium, to do it.
We will make cancer a disease of the past.